There's really only one viable option for our choice of u in this problem. If we have a square root function, whatever's inside the square root needs to just be a single variable, or else we can't integrate it. There's really no other algebraic simplification that we can do, so I think our only option is to choose u equals 4x plus 5. That makes our du 4dx, or in other words, that makes our dx 1/4 du. Well, that's pretty good. We can rewrite this square root of 4x plus 5 as the square root of u. And this dx we can rewrite as a 1/4 du, but we still have this x squared sitting in this integral. Is there a way that we can get rid of it? Well, fortunately, we can solve this equation here for x. Subtracting 5 from both sides and dividing by 4 gives us that x is the quantity u minus 5 divided by 4. Let's see what happens to our integral if we use those substitutions. We'll talk about limits in a second. The x squared turns into a u minus 5 over 4 squared. And as we said before, this next term turns into a square root of u. And the dx turns into a 1/4 du. The question now is, can we integrate this? And I think that we can. We can do a little bit of algebra, we can FOIL this thing right here, and then maybe we can distribute this u through the parentheses, pull all of our constants out in front, and that should be something that we can integrate. Which means that we may as well talk about our limits now. The lower limit of integration is x equals 0 here. So using our u substitution, we get that u will turn into 4 times 0 plus 5, which is 5. Our upper limit of integration is x equals 1, and using our u substitution, we get that that would make our u equal to 4 times 1 plus 5, which is 9. So here's the integral now that we have to deal with. Let's go ahead and start that simplification process. If we square our 4 in the denominator, that gives us a 16 in the denominator. That can go with the 1/4 to give us a 1/64 that we can pull out of our integral. Our next step would be multiplying or FOILing this u minus 5 squared. If we do that and combine like terms, we get this. And I'm going to go ahead and write the square root of u as u to the 1/2. That makes it easier to multiply that u to the 1/2 through the parentheses. And we're multiplying, so we're adding powers here. We're going to get u to the 2 plus 1/2. That's going to be u to the 5/2 power. If we multiply u times u to the 1/2, we're going to get u to the 3/2 power. And now we have something that we can use the power rule on. Adding 1 to each one of these powers, and then dividing by that power gives us, which we can simplify a bit. Then we just need to plug in our upper and lower limits of integration. And these numbers don't turn out to be so pretty, but if you plug all of this in to a calculator, or Wolfram Alpha, or Google, you should get an answer of approximately 0.94165. Okay, those last couple of lines weren't very much fun, but I think that was a pretty good substitution problem. I hope that the extra practice helps you out.